Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Vannon and today we're going to be continuing on with learning some useful building techniques in the game of Ark Survival Evolved. Today we're going to be learning about how we overcome awkward building locations. A lot of the really, really cool locations to build in Ark are not flat. Especially places like the island, which is the starting location in Ark, and where a few of you that may be coming to have a look at this channel may actually be at the moment. And I'm going to go through some techniques, and what you can see me currently stood on is a way of you being able to learn some of the different mechanics and how to actually overcome locations, which may be the perfect location that you want to build in, but you can't really get a great deal of foundation down. So let's go and have a look at what we have here. So what I've got here is how we overcome a slope like this. And how this is actually done is through a couple of different steps. Now you'll notice in here we've got foundations, we've got walls, we've got a ceiling here, we've got stairs, we've got all sorts. We've also got big gaps as well. How this is actually done is, first of all, you place the first foundation I placed was actually this one here. So if we move a little bit further down over here, what we need to do is we need to place a foundation like so. Like that. Now, we can't snap another foundation directly underneath there. The game doesn't allow us to do that. You can snap one there as long as you've got the no clipping settings, within the game itself, and we can place either side of here. But we want to either create a ramp system coming from down there up to there, or we want to create like a stepped kind of base. So how we achieve this is through the use of the actual steps themselves, the stairs. So if we place a stair going off like that, we can then snap a foundation because the base of the stairs here creates a snap spot for a foundation. Always going backwards like that. We then can we get another one on? No, we can't. So we then put another like that and then like that. That would then give us the ability to then go like that. So just by using the stairs and bringing them down, that then gives us the ability as so. Now, I can't snap the stairs on this other side here, on this far side, in order to build up. So I actually have to go like that and stick one there. We then can stick another stairs and put like that. Another stairs and like that. And putting the foundations here now means that we've got more snap points up here should we want them. So I can now actually get rid of those stairs and they actually stay where they are. Now for this purpose I shall need to build a little bit further out to demonstrate how we use the pillar technique, as otherwise the foundation support that we've created all the way along here would actually then give us foundation support moving out. So for instance, if I wanted to just build out from here, because we've already got all of those foundations down there, I can do. And the same on this side here. I can just build out as long as we have foundation support going along there. And of course, I've just run out of ceilings. So, where is my handy box? Full of stuff. So, as you can see, we're able to build out here, all the way along here, because of those foundations below. They're actually giving us foundation support below. So what we'll need to do is I shall choose to build over here. So we can go out two, but then it wants foundation support for that next one. So how do we do that? Well, we need to use pillars. I'll just move these around a little bit. So we stick a pillar down in the center there of that foundation, ceiling, sorry. And then what we want to do is we want to then bring it coming down. Now, if you just go to the next snap point, then what's going to happen is we stick that up there, come up here, pick up the pillar, and it didn't work. Wrong one. And we've got this unsightly protrusion at the top here, or commonly known as a nub. And we don't want them. They're unsightly, and we don't like them. So, what we do is we stick the pillar into there, come down here, and then what you're looking to do, just slowly bring your camera down. You should see it change. Say it just changed there. We'll do it again. Looking down, should change. Where it doesn't want to do it. See if I can get a better angle. So, there we go. Just there's another snap point. There you go. Just cycling through it there. Just top of the screen, you'll just see it change. There's just like that. And what that does is that allows for that. We did it first time by accident. But getting that lower snap point means that then you don't really see anything at all. There. If you were using, say, like a wooden ceiling and you use like a stone pillar, you will clearly see the stone square. But stone on stone, you don't. And then what we do, come down, bang, add another pillar into there. And now we can go out by another two. And there, stick the pillar in. Drop down. No nub. What we like. Like that. And then we could then come out even further. Now, another thing that you can do in these situations is when you've actually got the pillar in place, you can actually snap a foundation. So you'll notice there's a bit of a gap there. That's the gap that it snapped out from. and you've then got like so. So if I was to then go like that, oh, nighttime, we don't want that. And by the magic of admin commands, we have data. And there we can then build out. Now, because we've put that foundation snapped to the pillar, foundation there, we've then used the stair technique to then drop it down so we can then come out. And as we know, we can get rid of that. And we've still got everything in place. We've got the foundations going forwards. We will then be able to come out a certain distance. Now, why do we only get to there and we now need foundation support when we actually have the foundations underneath? It's because I deleted that, because it wasn't linked altogether. So the rules with this, yes, you can delete that, you can destroy these steps and get rid of them, but by doing so you're no longer linking these with these. So deleting it will mean that these still stay, but unfortunately it will then mean that they're no longer linked to the same building. Therefore, these up here, the ceilings, then won't get the foundation support. So you can see now that I've put those back in, we have now got foundation support again. Now, over here, I did something else. So I came out by three ceilings, and then I've stepped it down to being two ceilings. Now, how have I done that? Well, how I've done that is the same principle. Get rid of those. The same principle, if you remember, on the last video where I taught you how to make circular foundations and thus making circular buildings. It is the same principle. Let's have some of those. Don't need them. Them. Or them. Or any of that. So, if I build out like this with a three, and then there. And you'll now notice I've now dropped down to being two. Now you can imagine if I was to go like this. I could then start to build in a circular, like we did with the foundation on the last video. I shall endeavour to remind future me to put a little link in the top right hand corner, top left, right, one of them, the corners, to a link to that video. But now we can now build forwards, as it now stepping down from a three to a two. Now, where would that be useful? Well, a dino gate, for instance. A dino gate is two. Back here is three. So it means you'd have a doorway offset, and then you'd have to put a wall on the side. And as we've probably figured out by now, I like to build things that are visually pleasing as well as functional. So that there would then give you that ability to step down from three wide to being too wide. So today we have learned how to some of the techniques that are required for building in really awkward locations, whether it be you want to stick a base on top of a waterfall, or you want to build on the side of a mountain or on the side of a cliff, or wherever that awkward spot is that you've decided that you really like the look of that location, and there is exactly where you want to build. These are some of the techniques that you can use in order to actually do what you're looking to do. Now, in the coming next video is going to be building here on the island, on Herbivore Island, and we're going to try and bring all of the various techniques that I've shown you over the past few videos and bring them together to create a base here on Herbivore Island, but not here in the sort of crater area where so many people do choose to build. What I'm going to do, no, I'm not going to do anything in terms of easy for myself. What I'm going to do is I'm going to join those bits at the end there. So, if you enjoyed the video, found it useful, found any of the tips and tricks that I've shared today at all useful, if you want to be able to see this crazy base that I'm going to try and build in the next episode, then subscribe, chuck us a like, and as always, guys, none of this is the only way to build. There are tons and tons of different ways. You're going to find your own way as well. I'm just attempting to try and share my knowledge and make building an ark a little bit easier. So if you know a different way of doing something, please chuck it in the comments. If you've got any comments you want to share, anything that you may want me to cover in another video in the future, then feel free. Chuck it in the comments below, and we'll go from there. Guys, have a great day. I shall see you all soon.